Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on saving custom templates and importing them into Final Draft 9. For the purposes of this tutorial, I've created a script file here that has sample text and headers, footers, custom elements, and other aspects of a file that I'd like to save and reuse as a template. It also includes custom title page information, such as a custom title page header. All this information and more will be saved when I save as a template. In order to save this file as a template, I'll go to File and Export. I'll choose my desktop to save this script to, and I'll rename it however I like. Now I need to save this as an FDXT Final Draft template. Now that is the default choice, so I can leave that alone, and I'll click Save. I'll now have a copy of this on my desktop. From there, I'll find this script on my desktop, and I'll right-click and choose Copy. Now I just need to open a new Windows Explorer menu here, and I need to navigate to the folder that Final Draft is stored in. This is normally on your computer's C drive. So I'll go here and click on the C drive to see the contents of the C drive. If you have a 64-bit operating system, this will be located in Program Files x86, otherwise you'll go to Program Files. I'll find Final Draft 9 in this list of programs and open the Final Draft 9 folder. Then I'll open the Templates folder. Here I can choose which of the template categories I'd like to save my script template to. I'm going to choose Scripts. Once I'm in this menu, I can just right-click anywhere and choose Paste. I might have a warning like this come up. That's okay. That's expected. Just press Continue, and I should see my script template appear in this list. I'll close this, and then I need to exit Final Draft so that it can access that new template. So I will close and relaunch Final Draft 9. Once I have Final Draft 9 open again, I'll go to File and New from Template. I'll scroll through this list and find my template that I created. Once I click it, it opens a script copy of that template. Notice it is not actually opening the template itself, so I'm not going to be changing the template I made. You know that because the template name does not appear here. Rather, it says Untitled and then lists the template name. This means I'm not altering the template. If I were to make changes to this script, I'll click Save, and I'll create a new copy of my script. I'll click Save, and now my script has a new name, but I have not altered the template in any way. To prove it, I'll go to New from Template and open another copy of that template. You can see that the template has not been changed. This means that I can use this template again and again without making any changes to the file itself, but using it as a template to create new scripts. For more tutorials, visit finaldraft.com.